We are online.
Thank you, Leonardo. Welcome everyone to today's seminar. It's a pleasure to introduce Maria Emilia De Rossi, who is a staff scientific researcher at the Institute for Astronomy and Space Physics at CONICET, Universidad de Buenos Aires, Argentina, since 2010. Maria Emilia obtained a physics degree in 2005 and a PhD in 2009 in physics at the University of Buenos Aires. She has spent some time also visiting MPIA in Germany and the ICC in the UK. She is involved in different research projects related to galaxy formation and evolution since the early universe until the present. She performs this study by using numerical simulations of galaxy formation, semi-analytical techniques, and analytical models. At the moment, she is leading a very young group in Argentina, which is working on different projects related to the evolution of galaxies in cosmological simulations. Thank you so much, Maria Emilia, for accepting our invitation. You may start when you're ready.
Thank you, Anna. Well, first of all, I would like to thank you for having invited me to give a remote seminar here. It is a pleasure for me to share with you part of my research. In this talk, I will present the result of a project focused on the study of the chemical evolution of galaxies at different cosmic epochs, and in particular, I will discuss about metallicity scaling relations. This study makes use of the well-known Eagle simulations and has been done in collaboration with some members of the Eagle team. Here you can see a brief outline of the presentation. I'll begin with a brief introduction to the topic. Then I'll briefly describe the main simulations that we use. I'll continue showing our main result regarding the shape, evolution, and scatter of the mass metallicity relation. In particular, I will evaluate secondary metallicity dependencies at a given mass, such as the dependence on star formation rate, gas fraction, and stellar age. Especially, I'll present new prediction of Eagle simulations regarding the connection between the mass metallicity relation scatter and the internal morphokinematics of galaxies. These are very important findings of our work, as such trends were not previously reported in mass metallicity relation studies. Finally, I'll comment about a related project that we are carrying out, which tries to determine the importance of effective shields as tracers of feedback processes in galaxies. And I also mentioned briefly another ongoing project that is focused on the analysis of the stellar mass-stellar metallicity relation. And at the end, I will summarize our main findings and future goals. Well, I will begin with a brief introduction to the topic. In the local universe, there is a well-defined correlation between metallicity and stellar mass, in such a way that more massive galaxies are more chemical enriched at higher masses. This mass metallicity relation has been widely studied in the last decade, and in particular, it exhibits a steeper slope at low stellar masses and flattens towards the high mass end, extending over 4 dex in mass and around 1 dex in metallicity. I note that the study of the mass metallicity relation has become a very hot topic since the seminal paper of Tremonti et al. 2004, which has almost around 2,500 citations at the moment. The mass metallicity relations seems to evolve with redshift. Here we show results from the AMAZE project, and we can see how the mass metallicity relation evolves from redshift 3 to redshift 0. It is clear that at a given stellar mass, galaxies were less chemical enriched in the past. However, there are still controversies in the community about the exact level of evolution of this relation, as different metallicity indicators lead to different findings. In addition, selection biases and aperture effects makes the comparison between different observational data a very difficult task. regarding the scatter of the relation, Ellison 2008 reported that at a fixed stellar mass, observed galaxies with a smaller sizes or lower specific star formation rate tend to be more metal rich. And later, Lara Lopez et al. And Manucci 2010 suggested that the mass metallicity relation is just the projection onto two dimensions of a more fundamental relation between the star formation rate, the metallicity, and the stellar mass. In the right-hand panel, we show this fundamental metallicity relation, which, according to some author, could extend towards redshift 2.5. And in the left panel, we show the projection of such relation onto the mass metallicity plane. The relation is being according to the star formation rate. We see that at a given stellar mass, systems with lower metallicities tend to have higher star formation rate. Thus, part of the evolution of the mass metallicity relation might be caused by the fact that surveys at high redshift tend to select systems with elevated star formation rate, and hence the lower metallicity of high redshift galaxies could be related in part to their high star formation rate. Alternatively, it has been proposed that this 3D relation could result from a more fundamental relation underlying between the stellar mass, the oxygen abundance, and the gas fractions, since the gas fraction and the star formation rate correlate with each other. But unfortunately, large uncertainties remain in inferring physical relation from the data because different methods yield significantly different answers. In fact, some observational studies don't find that the scatter around the mass metallicity relation correlate with the star formation rate. And some other studies claim that the correlation exists but invert at high masses, for example. As mentioned at the beginning in this talk, I'll present results about the evolution of metallicity scaling relation in Eagle simulations. In this web page, you can find all the information about these simulations. Eagle simulations are a suite of cosmological hydrodynamical simulations run within periodic cubic volumes of size length between 25 and 100 comoving megaparsecs. The simulations were performed by using a modified version of the Gadget 3 code, and a lambda CDN cosmology is assumed with these cosmological parameters. In this talk, I will present results from the so-called intermediate and high-resolution runs. The physical model includes treatment for metallicity-dependent radiative cooling, star formation, feedback from supernovae 1A, supernovae 2, and HGB stars, and also feedback from HGNs. In this table, you can see a brief summary of the main simulation that we use. We will focus mainly on the high resolution run, which is the one that it is highlighted here. It corresponds to a size length of 25 comoving megaparsecs and a mass resolution of around 10 to the 5 solar masses and 10 to the 6 solar masses for baryons and dark matter, respectively. Well, for the intermediate resolution simulations, different physical models were explored. In the case of the reference model, the parameters associated to the energy feedback were calibrated to reproduce the local galaxy stellar mass function, the relation between galaxy mass and size, and the black hole mass stellar mass relation. But there are also other models which implement single parameter variation of the reference model. And in the case of the high resolution simulation, the reference model was applied, but also it was implemented a recalibrated model for which feedback parameters were recalibrated to obtain better agreement with the galaxy stellar mass function when working with the high resolution simulations. Well, to illustrate the cosmic evolution of galaxies in the simulation, I will show you a movie. Let me see if it works. Well, can you see the movie?
Yes.
Well, here it is, here you can see the evolution of the simulated box in Eagle simulation. Here, sorry, I will stop the movie. Here in the bottom right corner, you can see which mass component is shown, gas, stellar mass, or dark matter. And on the bottom left corner, you can see the redshift and size of the spatial region shown. And so you can see here how a galaxy form. You will see how a galaxy will form in the center of the movie. And you can see the important role of merger during the formation of the galaxy that appears in the center. At the end of the simulation, you will see that a galaxy with this line morphology is a form. For example, now you are seeing the evolution of the gas, but then you will see how also the stellar component. Now you see the distribution of the star, the stellar component in the central region. Well, and this is now the movie has finished, and now I will go to the presentation again. Well, once the simulations are run, in order to identify galaxies inside the simulation, the friends of friends method was applied, and also the well-known subfine algorithm. In general, we analyze the global properties of galaxies within an aperture of 30 kiloparsecs. But we check that our main general trends and findings are preserved if the aperture is changed. And in addition, we analyze the whole population of simulated galaxies without distinguishing between central and satellite systems within dark matter halos. But we check that similar results are obtained if considering only the population of central galaxies. Well, now I will start presenting the result that we obtained during the project. In this slide, you can see the local mass metallicity relation obtained from Eagle simulations. Here, the upper curves correspond to the intermediate resolution runs, while the lower curves depict the high resolution runs. Before comparing the simulated relation with observation, it is worth noting that the use of different metallicity indicators affect the observed mass metallicity relation normalization. And in some cases, the discrepancies can reach around 0.7 dex. Thus, when comparing our result with observations, we have to renormalize observed relation to match the simulation at high masses. In this way, we can focus the comparison on the shape of the relation as the normalization is a matter of controversies in observational studies. Well, here the symbols represent different observational results, which were renormalized as I said before. The intermediate resolution simulations predict a very flat slope at low masses in disagreement with observations. but we see that the high resolution version of the simulation describes better the observed trends. And in particular, the simulation that includes the recalibrated model, which is shown here in black, shows the best agreement with observation. And thus, we will focus mainly on this simulation during this presentation. In this plot, we analyze the level of evolution of the simulated mass metallicity relation in Eagle and compare it with observation reported by Han 2016 on the left and by Maiolino et al. 2008 on the right. We see that at a given mass, the simulated metallicity increases by around 0.5 dex, which is consistent with observational result obtained by Han 2016. However, other observations, like observation by Maiolino et al. 2008, suggest a stronger level of evolution than the simulated mass metallicity relation, which could be partly due to selection biases related to the existence of the fundamental metallicity relation, as I mentioned previously. I like to mention that Eagle simulations implement a more sophisticated subgrid physical models than that apply in previous versions of the same code. In particular, a few years before working with Eagle, I studied the mass metallicity relation in the so-called gimmick simulations. In this plot, I compare gimmick and Eagle mass metallicity relations. You can see that a gimmick predict a no significant evolution of the mass metallicity relation and a steeper slope toward higher masses, which is not consistent with observation as we showed before. In the case of Eagle, we found that the more significant evolution of the mass metallicity relation is caused by the dependence of the energy injection from supernovae 2 on local density and metallicity of the interstellar medium. On the other hand, when the injected energy is independent of local condition, like in the case of GMIC, we obtain a negligible evolution of the Eagle mass metallicity relation. A negligible evolution of the GMIC mass metallicity relation. And also for Eagle, the flattening of the mass metallicity relation at high masses is related to the inclusion of an AGN model. And AGN effects are not considered in the case of gimmick simulation. This is because this is why the gimmick slope is steeper. Well, the dependence of the mass metallicity relation on AGN feedback is a very interesting result obtained from Eagle. In this figure, we show the mass metallicity relation for different AGN models. The upper curve here, which is shown in black, corresponds to a model without AGN feedback. And the other curves correspond to model which implement different variation of the temperature increase of the gas caused by AGN feedback. Firstly, it is clear that AGN effects dominate only at high masses. When suppressing AGN feedback, the mass metallicity relation doesn't flatten at high masses in disagreement with observation. But as the delta T increases, the metallicity decreases, leading to an anticorrelation between mass and metallicity for the extreme case of 10^9 Kelvins. Also, AGN feedback tends to generate an increase of the scatter of the mass metallicity relation. Well, we have already discuss about the shape and evolution of the mass metallicity relation. But what does Eagle predict regarding the scatter of this relation? Well, we try to answer this question in this slide. and, well, the following ones also. In order to explore the origin of the scatter of the mass metallicity relation, we analyze the mass metallicity relation as a function of gas fraction, a specific star formation rate, and age. We can see that at low masses, metal poor systems tend to exhibit higher gas fraction, higher specific star formation rate, and lower stellar ages. And this is consistent with a scenario in which higher fraction of metal poor gas drive higher specific star formation rate in smaller galaxies. And consequently, these galaxies tend to be younger than more metal-enriched galaxies of similar masses. I acknowledge that recent work have confirmed the importance of accretion in the regulation of the metallicity evolution of Eagle galaxies. And in addition, we have a paper in preparation with more details about the connection of accretion event with the scatter of the mass metallicity relation. And at the massive end, there is a hint of an inversion of the dependence of metallicity on these parameters. And in particular, we found that AGN feedback can produce a decrease in the specific star formation rate in massive galaxies and the quenching of their chemical evolution. Eagle simulations are also able to reproduce a 3D relation between metallicity, stellar mass, and star formation rate, which follows the observed trends for the fundamental metallicity relation reported by Manucci et al. 2010. Here, the shaded surface depicts the observed relation, while the curves indicate the simulated mass metallicity relation for different star formation rate beams. And now, if I can, I will show you a more clear video prepared by my student Candela, which will show better the agreement between simulations and observations. But I think that I have problems to show the video. Oh, here it is. Well, in this video, you can see the comparison between simulations and observations in different angles. And so you can see that the agreement is very, very good. Okay. Well, but after a lot of analysis regarding the metallicity secondary dependencies, we found that the K-metallicity relation in Eagle simulations seems to be the relation between metallicity and gas fraction. In this plot, we show the metallicity as a function of gas fraction at different redshifts, and you see that as the gas fraction increases from 0 to 0.8, the metallicity decreases by around 1 dex. And this relation shows also a very moderate scatter. So as the relation between metallicity and gas fraction shows no significant evolution and only involves 2K global properties of galaxies, we conclude that it is more fundamental than the so-called fundamental metallicity relation between stellar mass, metallicity, and star formation rate, at least in these simulations. And our results are consistent with findings by Said et al. 2014, who claim that there is a universal metallicity relation between metallicity and stellar to gas ratio. Well, given that the scatter of the Eagle mass metallicity relation depends on gas fraction, star formation rate, and stellar age, and that such parameters can depend on the morphokinematics of galaxies, our next step in the analysis was to explore if there is a connection between the mass metallicity relation and the morphokinematics of simulated galaxies. As you see here, Eagle simulations can describe galaxies with different morphologies and so allow us to perform this kind of study for a statistical population of galaxies at different redshifts. So our question is, does the mass metallicity relation depend on the morphokinematics of galaxies? And the answer is yes. In this figure, we plot the Eagle mass metallicity relation with galaxies being according to the fraction of stellar kinetic energy of the galaxy that is invested in orbital rotation. This is kappa. We see that at the low mass end, dispersion supported galaxies have higher oxygen abundances than rotationally supported galaxies of the same mass. Also striking is that the oxygen abundances increases with mass for rotational supported galaxies, but it's almost independent of mass for dispersion supported galaxies. And as a consequence, the trend between the oxygen abundance and kappa inverts above a stellar mass of 10 to the 10 solar masses. And we at the high mass end, we have that massive dispersion supported galaxies have lower metallicities than rotationally supported galaxies of the same mass. And I didn't say before, but this result were obtained by using the intermediate resolution Eagle simulations. But if we use instead the high resolution Eagle simulation, we obtain similar trends. And well, similar results are obtained if using other morphokinematics parameters instead of kappa. For example, we obtain similar trends if we use the disk-to-total stellar mass ratio or the ratio between stellar rotation to velocity dispersion to characterize the morphokinematics. And these trends are new prediction of Eagle simulation that were not previously discussed in mass metallicity relation studies. In general, the main findings are the following. At low masses, higher metallicities are found in more spheroidal and lower rotation supported galaxies, while at high masses, lower metallicities are found in more prolate galaxies with lower level of rotationally support. The previous results combined with the dependence that, of the metallicity on the star formation rate, a specific star formation rate and gas fraction reported in our previous works, suggest that the morphokinematics may itself correlate with these other galaxy parameters. And we examine this in this figure. We see that independent of mass, we see that the gas fraction and a specific star formation rate increase with kappa, being the increase of the gas fraction the most pronounced for the lower mass galaxies, whereas the increase of the specific star formation rate is more evident for galaxies of high masses. We know that the star formation rate is a measure of the rate at which metal are produced, and the gas fraction can be considered a measure of the size of the reservoir that dilute those metals. We can say that a consequence of these trends is that the oxygen abundances decreases with increasing kappa at low masses, whereas it increases for high masses, while at intermediate masses of 10 to the 10 solar masses, the oxygen abundance does not depend on kappa. In this other figure, we analyze the connection between the mass metallicity relation and morphokinematics at higher redshift. And at a given redshift, we separated the galaxies according to the median value of kappa at that set redshift, at that redshift. And finally, we see that dispersion supported galaxies increasingly dominate at higher redshift as the median kappa decreases with redshift. And at increasing redshift, we also see that the trend between rotationally support and metallicity becomes weaker at the low mass end, but become more pronounced at higher masses. Well, in order to understand the origin of these obtained trends that are new in mass metallicity relation studies, we are performing a detailed analysis of the formation histories of our simulated galaxy population. And we have an article in preparation and that we hope to submit soon. But well, here I show some preliminary results that we have. Here in the left panel, we show the Eagle local mass metallicity relation being according to the cosmic time T50 when galaxies reach half of their present stellar mass. And it is clear that at the low mass end, systems with lower oxygen abundances tend to have formed at later times. And we have seen that these systems also show higher specific star formation rate, higher gas fraction, and are younger. Exhibited also higher rotational support and disky morphologies. An analysis of the formation history of this galaxy suggests that such trend could be associated with the accumulated effects of accretion of metal poor gas at late times, which this metal poor gas dilutes the metal content of galaxies, triggers their star formation activities, and contribute to the formation of the galaxy disks. The right panel shows the mass metallicity relation being according to the black hole stellar mass ratio. We note that massive galaxies with higher ratios of black hole to stellar mass tend to have lower metallicities. And this is consistent with a scenario where AGNs quench the metallicity evolution of galaxies by heating the gas, suppressing the star formation activity, and ejecting metal out of the systems. Thus, at the high mass end, less metal enriched systems have lower specific star formation rate, lower fraction of star forming gas, and higher ages. And such systems tend also to be dispersion supported on average. And a preliminary analysis of the merger histories of Eagle galaxies suggests that massive galaxies with lower metallicities seem to have been subject to major merger event, which inhibited the formation of a disk and also contributed to the increase of the central black hole mass. This is a study which is in progress. The complete analysis of the formation histories of Eagle galaxies and its connection to the scatter of the mass metallicity relation will be presented in a forthcoming article, as I mentioned. Well, finally, I will briefly comment about other related project that we are carrying out with Maritza Lara Lopez and her research group. This project involves the oxygen shields. Well, the goal of this project is to understand the role of shields as tracer of feedback processes in galaxies by comparing observational data and simulations. As a brief reminder, the effective shields are calculated by using this expression where the set represents the metallicity and mu the gas fraction. And you know that effective shields will be constant for galaxies that evolve as closed box, but feedback processes generate deviation from the closed box model. In Lara Lopez et al. 2019, we found a very good agreement between the simulated and observed relation between effective shields and baryonic mass in galaxies, in Eagle. And our findings indicate that AGN feedback must have played an important role in the history of massive galaxies by quenching their star formation rate, whereas low mass galaxies would have been affected by a combination of outflow and infall of gas. And at the moment, we are extending such analysis as part of the Lacenshit thesis of Candela-Servo. By exploring the effective shield at higher redshift, we found that not only AGN feedback, but also merger event seem to play a key role on the evolution of effective shield for galaxies in massive halo. So this is a parallel study that we are doing in connection with the mass metallicity relation. And finally, I would like to mention another related project that we are carrying out, which is the study of the mass metallicity relation, but based on stellar metallicity instead of gas phase ones. In the Rossi et al. 2017, we found that Eagle predicts a stellar mass, stellar metallicity relation, which evolves in shape and normalization since redshift 3. You can see the plot here. And in particular, we obtain that at redshift 0, simulations and observations agree at high masses, but at low masses, simulated metallicities are higher on average. At redshift greater than 0, simulations and observations agree within the errors in the range of mass where they overlap. We are resuming at the moment this analysis, and we will try to compare simulations with more recent observation and understand the connection between the gas phase and stellar mass metallicity relations. Well, here is a summary of the presentation and future work. Well, we analyzed high resolution Eagle simulation, and we found that the simulation predicts a correlation between stellar mass and metallicity, which is consistent with observations. At high masses, the flattening of the mass metallicity relation is regulated by AGN feedback according to our findings. But at low masses, the slope of the mass metallicity relation seems to be mainly modulated by stellar feedback. Simulations predict also a 3D relation between stellar mass, star formation rate, and metallicity in agreement with observations. But the correlation between metallicity and gas fraction seems to be more fundamental, because it exhibits a moderate scatter and does not show a significant evolution, at least in this simulation, and is consistent with a previous work which report the existence of a universal metallicity relation between metallicity and gas fraction. We also report new prediction of Eagle simulation regarding the connection between the mass metallicity relation scatter and the internal morphokinematics of galaxies, and such trends were not previously reported in mass metallicity relation studies. In a forthcoming article, we address the origin of these metallicity secondary dependencies by analyzing the formation histories of different galaxy populations. And a related project are the study of effective shields in simulations to determine their role as tracers of feedback processes at different redshifts, which is part of the Candela-Servo's thesis. And we are also analyzing the connection between the gas phase and stellar metallicities. The main result discussed here can be found in these three papers if you are interested to know more details. And Well, thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your talk, Maria Emilia. For the people following the talk on YouTube, thank you for joining us. If you have any questions, please post them in the YouTube channel chat. Next week, we won't be having a seminar as it's a holiday, and we'll be back in 2 weeks from now. Goodbye. Now, breakout rooms.